Planet Earth is under threat. Thousands of wild animals are in danger of becoming extinct. CBBC has decided to find out what's being done to save them. Last year, a nationwide search was launched by CBBC to find a group of children who care passionately about wildlife to make up a Saving Planet Earth challenge team.
Wow! Did you see that one,
The prize, a trip of a lifetime to see some of the world's most endangered animals and look at the work that's been done to help them. One of the finalists was 10-year-old Alex Hewitt from Cambridge. Wildlife presenter Michaela Strachan helped to choose the winners.
Congratulations on getting this far. You've all been really, really good. And I'm here to tell you that you are going.
Yeah!
On your Saving Planet Earth trip of a lifetime! Yay!
I couldn't believe it when Michaela told me I'd won. I never expected it. I love wildlife and regularly visit the Zoology Museum in Cambridge with my mum, dad and sister Ellie. I'm particularly interested in reptiles like lizards and iguanas.
I just love reptiles because they've been around for ages and ages and ages and they are not like us at all. I mean, they've got the same skeletons, but they're just so different because they have to warm up with the sun's energy.
Wildlife presenter Sir David Attenborough is my hero. 4 years ago, I wrote to him and got a letter back which I've kept under lock and key ever since.
There! The blue whale is 100 feet long.
I think David Attenborough's amazing. He's the best naturalist that's ever lived. And I just really want to be like him when I grow up.
I didn't know where in the world I was going to be sent, but there was one place I was desperate to go where there are loads of reptiles.
I would most like to go to the Galapagos because it's been undiscovered for ages and ages and the animals there are absolutely stunning.
I'd been told to expect a message from the Saving Planet Earth team.
Congratulations, Alex. You've done remarkably well to be selected as a member of the Saving Planet Earth Challenge team. And I'm delighted to tell you you're going to go to one of the most exciting places on Earth, the Galapagos.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Good luck.
Absolutely amazed that the company David Attenborough actually filmed a special message for me.
Galapagos is like nowhere else on Earth. It's home to amazing wildlife, such as giant tortoises, marine iguanas, and blue-footed boobies. Galapagos is a group of remote islands in South America. It belongs to Ecuador and lies 600 miles off the mainland. People are only allowed to live on 5 of the 14 islands. The others are devoted to wildlife. But the animals are under threat, and it was my mission to find out why.
What's that?
After a very long journey, it was time to board the boat that would be my home for the next 10 days.
Hola, mi nombre es Alex.
In Galapagos, everyone speaks Spanish, so I tried to learn a few words.
Pollo.
That means chicken in Spanish. I'm going to go meet the captain now. Hola. Mi nombre es Alex. Mucho gusto.
Mi nombre es Washington.
I'm a little bit worried about getting seasick because the waters here are quite choppy, but it's definitely going to be worth it to see the wildlife.
Galapagos is most famous for its giant tortoises. They're the biggest in the world, weighing up to 250 kilos. They can live up to 200 years. There used to be hundreds of thousands of them, but now they're under threat. The most famous of all the giant tortoises is Lonesome George. There are several different species of giant tortoise, but he's the only one of his kind left in the world, and I really wanted to meet him. So my first stop was the Charles Darwin Research Station where he lives.
Oh, there you go.
Wow. Oh, so big.
Look at you.
Very few people are allowed to get this close to Lonesome.
Lonesome George?
Richard was my guide and knows Galapagos really well.
How old is Lonesome?
Well, that's a good question. They say between 60 and 80 years old, but it's very difficult to tell the age of a giant tortoise.
He's about the same height as me when he lifts his neck.
I know he is, isn't he? He's very curious about you.
Yeah.
Lonesome comes from an island called Pinta. 35 years ago, he was discovered there on his own. It had been thought that the Pinta tortoise was extinct. One of his rescuers was Fausto, and he's looked after him ever since. Richard offered to translate.
What does Lonesome George do all day?
¿Qué hace solitario Jorge todo el día?
Un momento, tres de la tarde ya está para a dormir.
Sounds to me like he's got a really pretty cushy life here, Alex. He loves eating. Big appetite.
Un árbol muy grande y él comió, comió y comió.
Oh, that's funny. Mm-hmm. He said that one of the cactus trees fell in the pen and no one was watching it and he just had his fill of cactuses. He was sick for 3 days, can you imagine?
Oh, he's bigger than his stomach.
Yeah.
Is he actually lonely? Because in the Guinness Book of World Records he says he's the loneliest animal on the planet.
Yeah, you know, they've been looking for another Pinta tortoise all over the world for the last 20 years, but they haven't found one yet. But, you know, he also has a couple of females in here with him, so he's not alone in this pen, at least.
I can't imagine that anyone wouldn't feel that they had to do something if they knew that, if they could see him here.
I know, you're dead right about that.
It makes me feel really sad to know that once he dies, the whole species is gone like that.
I found out that humans are the reason tortoises are so threatened. Hundreds of years ago, huge numbers were killed by pirates and whalers for food on board their ships. Then, as people began to live on the islands, they brought with them animals such as goats and pigs, which were never on the islands originally. Goats destroy the tortoises' habitat, pigs eat their eggs. The other tortoises at the research station have been rescued from other islands and brought here to stop them suffering the same fate as Lonesome George. Fausto has successfully run a breeding program and they've had lots of babies.
Wow! Wow, oh my gosh! Oh, they're so tiny!
Tortuguitas.
So Fausto's going to show you how to measure and weigh tortoises and then you're going to do it from then on.
Okay. Oi, 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 oi. Ay, your claws are sharp. Okay, you can stop wriggling. Getting a bit frisky. 22.2.
22.2, yeah.
850. 20.3. I know it can't be nice doing this, but it's very important to do. You've got to know how healthy you are. It's almost over now. There you go. You did very well.
Fausto was planning to return some of these tortoises to the wild, so we had to put identity chips in them. I really wanted to help him. He promised if the conditions were right while I was in the Galapagos, he'd call me. Although reptiles are my favourite animals, birds on Galapagos are like nowhere else on Earth. There was one I was really curious about, and I was hoping wildlife expert Mateus would help me find it.
Usually these are more a little insect.
There's a Galapagos hawk! Mm-hmm. He's magnificent. I can't believe how close we can get to him. Look, there's a frigate bird.
but I really wanted to see a blue-footed booby.
Look how close they're getting.
I'd read that it has bright blue feet and a strange mating ritual.
I just can't really believe how many animals there are in this one place. It's a blue-footed booby. I couldn't believe how blue their feet were. It was absolutely incredible to see them. They're just such a vibrant blue. Do the boobies actually dance?
Oh, it's very funny, you know, when they do this kind of dance of love, you know, male and female are pushing up their legs, dancing very strange, like clowns, you know, with blue feet.
Do you think I could dance with it?
Well, right now you can try it.
Okay. Ooh!
You're a huge male for her.
Ooh! Oh, come on. You've got to be impressed. The biggest male you've ever seen. It was so funny to dance with the blue-footed booby because she was kind of psyching me out and saying, oh, he's okay. I don't think she's giving it to me. I think she's giving it to the male over there. The male's kind of like, I want her, and kind of chase me away. They're dancing. Oh, the reason the islands have such incredible animals is because, unlike most islands, they've never been attached to a mainland. They're actually the tips of huge submarine volcanoes that rose out of the sea. There were no animals there originally. Any wildlife that lives there got to the islands under their own steam, either by flying, swimming, or floating on bits of wood.
There's a sally-footed light crab.
This is why most of the animals are birds and reptiles. We were on the lookout for a rather large lizard.
Oh, there's one there!
It was a land iguana and it looked prehistoric.
Wow. He's just amazing. He's just so still. And he's got a really interesting coloration because he's yellow. Almost totally, and then it's completely black.
Mm-hmm. Like all reptiles, iguanas have to heat up with the sun to get energy. Once they're warm, they can move quite fast. A close relation to the land iguana is the marine iguana. It lives by the sea and is the only true marine lizard in the world. It eats algae and can dive up to 10 metres. There used to be loads of iguanas in Galapagos, but now they're threatened. They're often attacked by cats and dogs. Iguanas aren't used to predators and can't compete with them. But I discovered there is a solution. A charity called Animal Balance has set up a project to encourage people to be more responsible for their pets. They neuter cats and dogs to stop the population increasing and hold dog training days. 14-year-old Jaime invited me along with his dog, Lara.
Good, Lara.
Animal Balance work is very important because they teach us how to protect our wildlife by teaching us our responsibility with our pets.
After the dogs have had a health check, their owners are given free collars and leads and told how important it is not to let their animals roam freely on the beach where they can easily attack marine iguanas.
I think the solution that Animal Balance has come up with is a very good one because it's very simple
and everyone benefits. The non-native species get to live healthier and stronger, and the native species get to live like they have for millions of years.
To help protect iguanas, Fausto and his team at the Charles Darwin Research Station set up a breeding program to increase their numbers. Today, I'm going to help release some of them into the wild.
Hello?
It's fine, you're going to be fine.
We're taking it down to a truck to be released on an island called Boltra.
It was going to be a long journey for the iguanas.
I've got it.
We had to get a move on as it was very hot and we didn't want them to get stressed. Boltra is run by the Ecuadorian military. It's 2 years since the last group of iguanas was released here, so there was a lot of interest. We had more than 40 iguanas to set free. I was going to release the very first one.
Yes, he's alive. Oh.
I was worried it might bite me. When
I first came here, I never thought I'd even get to touch a land iguana, let alone hold one and set it free.
Release it.
Whoa! And he's off. He's a wild iguana now. Bye. Oh, another one. Whoa, he's fast. I'm sure they're going to enjoy their new life here.
Next morning, I decided to carry on my mission underwater.
I would still really like to see the work that's being done to save green turtles, because green turtles are another creature that I really like and am awestruck by.
But before I had a chance to look, a group of sea lions appeared that I just had to check out. I really wanted to find the turtle. I was sure there must be one around somewhere. This was what I was after.
I've just seen a sea turtle! Turtles are endangered because they get caught in fishing nets, and of course they can't get out of the fishing nets, and they die by getting cut by the hooks and stuff.
I was keen to find out more. I knew the Charles Darwin Station was carrying out some research into sea turtles. And I'd heard there were a few beaches where no one apart from researchers were allowed to go.
Oh, yeah.
Patty, the marine biologist in charge of the turtle project, took me to one where turtles are sometimes known to come up onto the beach in the daytime.
When we first saw it in the distance, I just couldn't believe it. I never thought that I would see a turtle basking. I never thought I would.
So we will try not to disturb her. Let's see if she's got a tag.
Oh, wow.
See? We put a tag here.
From its tag, we knew this female turtle had visited the beach at least 8 times before.
So we know what she has been doing lately, because we have a history of her. So we can tell a story.
She's just staring at us.
Yeah, she's looking at us.
But she's fine. She probably is more than 50 years old. She's very big. She's an old lady.
She is.
They feel safe here.
Yeah.
So we need to keep this place as safe
as possible.
As possible. Yeah, you're right.
Patty and her team are trying to find out what the main threats to green turtles are, apart from fishing nets, so they can help protect them in future.
The people I've met on Galapagos that are doing work love animals as much as I do, maybe even more, and I'm just honoured to have met them, and I'm going to take a bigger role in conservation.
The conservation I really wanted to help with was releasing the baby tortoises into the world. But time was running out and there was still no word from Fausto. In the meantime, I was invited to help out a group of children who were doing their bit for conservation. They work with a charity called Ecology Project International. Galapagos isn't just under threat from alien species of animals, it's also threatened by alien species of plants.
This is a big one.
People who have come to live here have started growing trees and shrubs that were never here originally.
We're doing this because the blackberries, they're not from here, from the Galapagos, and they're getting everywhere and they're dominating the other species that live here, and if we don't clear these, then they'll basically take over all of the natural plants here.
And that's bad news for the animals.
It's very important that we get rid of introduced plants so that animals like the tortoises eat the right ones.
This is the fifth time I've been here to do this. I'm worried all the animals are going to die in Galapagos.
If Galapagos isn't protected, many of the animals will disappear and the islands will be completely forgotten.
I think the conservation work is amazing at how much effort people have been putting in to save this paradise.
My trip was nearing an end when I finally had a call from Fausto to say he was planning to release the tortoises the next day on an island called Española. We were a long way away. We could sail through the night, but I didn't think we'd get there in time.
My dream country would be to get to release a baby giant tortoise back into the wild. It would just be absolutely incredible.
As dawn broke, we finally reached the island, but there was no sign of Fausto and his team. I really hoped we hadn't missed them. All we could do was wait.
Alex.
Hola.
Richard.
¿Cómo estás?
¿Qué tal?
¿Cómo vas?
Hola.
¿Cómo has pasado?
Estoy llegando.
Ahí no me...
Oh, wow. These were the tortoises I'd weighed and measured the previous week.
I can't even lift it off the ground.
We had a long trek ahead, so the tortoises had to be transferred into bags. We were going to release the tortoises high up inland as there's more vegetation for them to eat.
That walk was really tough. It was just so hard to do it in 30 degree heat. That's
some point, while we were climbing up, we were getting on a really difficult stretch of rocks, and I just thought, I can't do this. I'm really, really tired. Just really out of breath, and I'm sweating like mad.
We were up against time as the tortoises were getting hotter and hotter inside the bags.
I just kind of got my senses together and forced myself to do it. I knew that I would never get another chance to do this, so I had to finish.
Alex, a la final hemos llegado. Estamos ya en el lugar donde se repatrian las tortugas. Estamos aquí en Española.
Fossa says, finally we've arrived after that long journey. Oh, and this is the place we're going to repatriate the tortoises.
Releasing the tortoises was a dream come true, to see and know that I am doing something to save Galapagos. The work that Fausto is doing is extremely important because it opens people's eyes to see that Galapagos is in danger.
Before this breeding program began, there were only 14 tortoises left on Española. Now there's a healthy population.
Good luck in the big wide world. It's been more than a dream come true. It's been 1,000 dreams come true.
The message I'm going to take back home to England is that Galapagos is a very special place, and it would just be a tragedy to lose its wildlife.